Welcome back, guys. So I owe you an inventory exposition. That is what I'm here to do today. Couldn't get it done on the last video, but want to go into the country as a whole, drill down into Florida, obviously head down into Southwest Florida and discuss some more of the reasons why our inventory is exploding. And it actually does look like it might be the worst in the nation. There are areas that have higher percentage inventory growth than us, but it's very few and these are very limited listings. So, you know, one area in Kansas has like 600% inventory growth. It went from 5 listings to 25 listings. You know what I mean? It's so volatile there because it's small. We really seem to be getting it the worst. So let's jump right in. All right, guys, I'm gonna kick this off with the Reventure app. Seems pretty accurate. It's pretty close to the numbers I've got. Again, I don't have December's numbers, but they are showing here 26.8% inventory increase for December for this whole state of Florida. 26.8% going from almost 90,000 listings to 113,000. Why that is significant? Well, it's the highest in the country. We have added the most listings percentage-wise than anywhere else in the United States right now. That's not good. Louisiana trailing behind us at 26.5%, Mississippi at 24%, Nebraska at 20%, but really, that's it for over 20%. And we, you know, Tennessee's at 13%, Alabama at 18.6%. So the South region, Texas at 13.5%, really starting to blow up. Surprisingly, Arizona down 13%, California down 13%, Nevada down 40%, Utah down 6%, New York down 9%. So a lot of questions we get is every time, you know, I'm out in public, people who know I'm a real estate agent are always asking, are we still getting a lot of Californians? Are we still getting a lot of New Yorkers to move here? I mean, it doesn't appear so. I don't see a lot of California plates, especially here in Southwest Florida. I get a lot of Midwestern plates, some Pennsylvania, mostly Midwestern stuff. But, you know, the narrative is that everyone's fleeing these states. Well, where's all their inventory? Why hasn't their inventory spiked? But ours has. So whose state are they really fleeing? So guys, that's just data. Don't really care what your political affiliation is, but the numbers don't match up to some of the narratives and people ask me about. So I wanted to point that out. Tallahassee's inventory growth sitting at, well, shoot you, get out of my way. Sitting at 11.4%. Jacksonville's inventory down 4.9%. So some of that people, you know, want to keep going to cities that we see here. Let's head West Coast. Marion in the center is down 23%. Citrus County up 18%, Sumter up 6.6%, Hernando down 7.9%, Pasco up 7.5%, Tampa staying flat about 0.5%, still staying hot in Tampa. Clearwater, Pinellas starting to pick up, 36% increase in listings. That's interesting. Gonna see the same thing over here in Broward, 30% more listings than last year. Indian River, again, still nothing as dark as Southwest Florida, but we'll get over there. St. Lucie up 23, Martin up 31, Palm Beach up 26%, Broward up 26%, Miami-Dade up 8.1%. So obviously the trend here, guys, all across Florida, mostly going up, mostly getting a lot of listings. And it's year over year, so it's not a seasonal thing. You know, this is compared to last December. Collier jumping 56%, Lee County up 99%. This is where Southwest Florida is really taking the cake. DeSoto up 101%, Charlotte up 151% for December. That's pretty accurate. In November, we were at about 2,500 single family listings. He's got the total inventory here at 2,900. That may include condos. Sarasota up 87% year over year, almost doubling their listings. Manatee up 54%. So guys, you can see the illustration that I've been expressing here. There is a clear epicenter of what's going on. It's down here in Southwest Florida. It is starting to spread to the state. Now, with that being said, let me take you over to the home price growth because not really showing up yet. I mean, we've got a lot more inventory. I don't know how many months of inventory these places have, but as you can see across the panhandle, there's no prices down. Everything is either is pretty much up across the board. Surprisingly, Jacksonville down very slightly year over year, 2.7%, followed by Clay at 2.6, St. John's. And, you know, you got to go south to see a little more, any price declines really at this point. Let's head down to Hillsborough. Hillsborough down 0.4%, sitting at a median sales price of 384. Clearwater up slightly, Pasco down slightly. So no real big movements, you know, Hardy up 5%. Oh, good for you guys. But then we start getting into Sarasota, down 0.9%, DeSoto 1.1%, Charlotte 3.1%, which is in line with what I've seen. Cape Coral down 0.8% year over year. Now remember, guys, this is just December. When people look at this and they go, oh, 3% year over year, you know, who cares? When it's 3% year over year for the past 12 months, that starts to add up. That starts to be 36%. You understand? So that's some of the things we've been seeing here. Haven't seen a lot of price growth in Charlotte, though my numbers were going to show that Charlotte was going to go up slightly in December. So I'll have to see what comes in my preliminaries. But it's definitely nowhere near the peak. Miami-Dade up 7.4% on their closed prices. Broward up 5.9%. Palm Beach up 3%. Hendry. So guys, we have all this additional inventory, but still prices are still going up in a lot of areas. Not in Southwest Florida. Again, is this the canary in the coal mine? As you guys have mentioned, I don't know. We'll see. Now, these numbers are really going to blow you away, guys. These are my trailing seven-day numbers for my local MLS, my area. Covers Northport down to Punta Gorda. Also have Inglewood in there. Let's take a look. New listings sitting at 267 for the past 7 days. We have only sold 61 of those. That is a 25% accuracy rate. That's bad, guys. That's bad in Battleship if you're only hitting one of four shots. That's not good. We did pend 162, but that's still only about two-thirds of the new listings we put on, and that doesn't count everything that's already out there. So clearly, we're up 100 listings, and I'd wager it's probably even less than that because 56 of those came back on the market. So about one-third of deals falling through here. That's pretty historical. For the past 2 years, we're losing about one out of three contracts will fall out. It's usually 25 was what I used to see, but it's can go up to about one third. So if you're getting an offer on your house, there's a one in three chance it's not gonna make it to closing for various reasons, insurance, all the things we've been through, not gonna go through it. But that's almost tied with how many we're selling. So we're selling 61 and 56 are falling apart. That's crazy. 324 price decreases, guys. 324. That's way more than the listings. That is crazy. That's the reality of what's going on down here. And, you know, there's a lot of cheerleading talk on social media from loan officers, from other agents. It's like, oh, it's the buyers are back. The interest rates went from 7% to 6.5%. Everyone's off the fence. Well, even if everyone's off the fence at 162 pending sales, it's still nowhere close to what we need to start taking inventory off the market. This is showing the inventory is continuing to build. Also, I really don't know how true that is. And to be quite honest with you guys, unfortunately, after that inflation report we just got and the 10-year moving again, I think we're gonna be back over 7% interest rates here very shortly, and that always grinds this area to a halt. I don't know about where you guys are, but 7% and over usually gets us pretty good. Now, since the last time we hit a major 7% milestone, we did it in the fall, you know, obviously it was over that, but really last spring was the first time we saw 7% interest rates, and we've seen price depreciation since then. So can some of that, you know, will that close some of the gap? I don't know. We'll see, but I did want to show you this because it's just mind blowing. Also want to use this recent article from realtor.com to illustrate the inventory growth a little more. Building boom, it states, top 10 places for buyers to find newly constructed homes in 2024. I want to show you their methodology before I show you the results. So they state, for those who are ready to consider a new home, the realtor.com data team found the metropolitan areas with the most new residential construction in the pipeline relative to the number of existing homes. And they illustrate that here on this chart. And look at number one, guys. Wouldn't you know it? Good old Southwest Florida, specifically my hometown of Punta Gorda, pulling almost 5,000 new build permits last year. Now, as you'll see, Austin, Texas has 35,000. They had the most, but we have pulled the most new construction permits as compared to our existing homes in the country. All right, guys, so I wanted to get all those inventory numbers out to you. I did owe them to you. I appreciate you checking them out. If you like this video, let me know what you think in the comments. Give me a like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.